Penguin Random House Audio presents 1,000+ Little Habits of Happy, Successful Relationships. Written and read by Marc and Angel Chernoff. This is Marc Chernoff.
To all the amazing humans we've met who have added value to our lives and to the lives of others.
Introduction. We are all in this together, this wild world we live in. So always be kinder than necessary. What goes around, comes around. No one has ever made themselves strong by showing how small someone else is. Everyone you know, love, or meet is learning something, is afraid of something, cares deeply about something, and has lost something. You know this, so keep doing your best to be extra kind today. Be compassionate in whatever way you can. Be a beacon of hope to people you pass on the street. Embody what you know in your heart is right. And keep in mind that many of the kindest gestures you'll ever make and the most important things you'll ever do won't come easy and will never be seen publicly, but they are worth doing anyway.
Let this book be your guide, your source of daily inspiration, to stay on track in your relationships and interactions with others. Digest one article at a time with your morning coffee or your evening tea, and we promise that you won't just grow in knowledge, you'll be a person who gives back too. This book will inspire you to use what you're learning and what you know to make a difference, to be a blessing, to be a friend, to encourage someone, to take time to care, to let your words heal and not wound. You have the power to improve someone else's day, perhaps even their whole life, simply by giving them your sincere presence, compassion, and kindness today. And by doing so, you have the power to transform your life too. What would it be like to open up your heart instead of closing it? What would it be like to notice your inner narratives and move through them into growth, into peace of mind, and real connection? That's precisely the direction we're heading in. We're going to explore how the time you invest in creating both healthy relationships and healthy mindsets about your relationships can affect almost everything else you do in life. It's how you can truly make a difference in this world. But before we begin, let's get one timeless lesson crystal clear. Happiness and success in life don't start solely with your relationships. They start with your thinking and what you tell yourself today. In other words, the real journey of nurturing healthy relationships starts with mindful inner calmness.
On a chilly evening 20 years ago, after spending nearly every waking minute with Angel for 8 straight days, I knew I had to tell her just one thing. So late at night, just before she fell asleep, I whispered it in her ear. She smiled, the kind of smile that makes me smile back. And she said, "When I'm 75 and I think about my life and what it was like to be young, I hope I can remember this very moment." A few seconds later, she closed her eyes and fell asleep. The room was peaceful, almost silent. All I could hear was the soft purr of her breathing. I stayed awake thinking about the time we'd spent together and all the choices in our lives that made this moment possible. And at some point, I realized it didn't even matter what we had done or where we had gone, nor did the future hold any significance. All that mattered was the serenity of the moment, just being with her and breathing with her. Why did I just share that personal story with you? Because doing so helps remind me, and I know you need a reminder sometimes too. Sometimes we all need to be reminded of the beauty and sweetness of truly absorbing ourselves into the present moment, into the people, the dialogues, and the priceless little gifts that exist there. We need to be reminded what it's like to truly be present and accepting and at peace. Because too often, amidst the drama and chaos of life, we forget. We forget to simply be and breathe with those around us. We forget to appreciate the beauty they possess despite their flaws.
The human superpower of calmness. The most fundamental aggression to ourselves and others, the most fundamental harm we can do to human nature as a whole on a daily basis, is to remain ignorant by not having the awareness or courage to look at ourselves and others honestly and gently. All day, every day, many of us get annoyed with people and their situations when they fail to live up to our expectations, as if their reality isn't enough for us and never will be. We reject these people as their problems somehow seem different from our own. We feel like we need something better, something more from them, and we scream inside. We let our emotions and anxieties get the best of us, and we blind ourselves to the truth. The truth is, when someone upsets us, this is often because they aren't behaving according to our fantasy of how they should behave. The frustration, then, stems not from their behavior, but from how their behavior differs from our fantasy. Let this sink in. And let's not get carried away going forward. Calmness is a human superpower. Regardless of the situation, the ultimate measure of our wisdom and strength is how calm we are when facing the situation. The ability to not overreact or take things personally keeps our mind clear and our heart at peace, which instantly gives us the upper hand against the stress, fear, and confusion of the moment.
Being calm under pressure. Over the past decade, we have gradually been cultivating in ourselves a new way of being. We've been taming our tendencies to get angry and irritated with people when their behavior doesn't match our expectations. We all get frustrated when things don't play out the way we expect them to, and when people don't behave like they're supposed to. We expect our spouses and children to act a certain way, our friends to be kind and agreeable, strangers to be less difficult, life to be easier, and so on and so forth. And when reality hits us and everyone and everything seems to be doing the opposite of what we want, we feel pressure inside, and then we overreact with anger, frustration, stress, tears, and so forth. So what can we do about this? Breathe and think better. You can't control how other people behave. You can't control everything that happens to you. What you can control is how you respond to it all. In your response is your greatest opportunity.
When you feel like your lid is about to blow, take a long, deep breath. Deep breathing releases tension, calms down our fight or flight reactions, and allows us to quiet our anxious nerves so that we choose more considerate and constructive responses, no matter the situation. So, for example, do your best to inhale and exhale the next time another driver cuts you off in traffic. In a poll we conducted with our most recent Think Better, Live Better event attendees, overreacting while fighting traffic was the most commonly cited reason for overreacting on a daily basis. Just imagine if all the drivers on the road took deep breaths before making nasty hand gestures or screaming obscenities at others. There's no doubt that it can drive us crazy when we don't get what we expect from people, especially when they are being rude and difficult. But trying to change the unchangeable, wanting others to be exactly the way we want them to be, just doesn't work. The alternative, though, is unthinkable to most of us. To breathe, to let go, to lead by example, and to accept people even when they irritate us.
Here's the way of being that we have been cultivating and advocating. To be truly present, to breathe deeply and often, to remind ourselves that we can't control other people, to remind ourselves that other people can handle their lives however they choose, to not take their behavior personally, to see the good in them, even when it's hard, to let go of the ideals and expectations we have about others and life in general that cause unnecessary frustration, drama, and bouts of anger.
To remember that when others are being difficult, they are often going through a difficult time we know nothing about, and we should give them empathy, love, and space. Being this way takes practice, but it's worth it. It makes us less frustrated. It helps us be more mindful. It drastically improves our relationships. It lowers our stress, and it allows us to make the world a slightly more peaceful and lovable place to be.
Now it's your turn to instill a little more love into this world, even when there's no great love story to tell. To love the people you are with as much as feasibly possible until you can be with the people who truly deserve your love. Fewer outbursts, less drama, more deep breaths, presence, and love. Ultimately, this is the way we find calmness, peace, and new opportunities in life.
Let's practice starting today together.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.